kafa. Wassalatu wassalamu ala ibadihi alladhina astafa. Khususan ala afdalihim wa khatamin nabiyyin Muhammadin al-Amin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in wa ba'd. Brother Chairman, respected Imam, brothers and sisters, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Wa alaikum salam wa rahmatullahi.
Begin we begin with Allah's blessed name. We praise Him and we glorify Him as He ought to be praised and glorified. And we pray for peace and for blessings on all His noble messengers, and in particular on the last of them all, the blessed Prophet Muhammad sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. And we thank Allah for the opportunity to be with you here in Masjid al-Husna, in Sunway Pyramid in Kuala Lumpur in Malaysia. I got it right?
Yeah.
To address you on a subject which is not simple, not easy, and yet of critical importance. In fact, the government of Malaysia should be here to listen. The subject of Dajjal and the Samawat. Dajjal and the Samawat. We begin the lecture by defining who or what is Dajjal. We then proceed to explain his mission that Allah gave to him. And then to try to assess how much of that mission he has already accomplished and how much remains. And if he has already accomplished part of his mission, where is he? And that will take us to the Samawat. Let us, at the very beginning, point out that there is a profound difference between Islamic scholarship and secular scholarship. Even if the secular scholarship declares Alhamdulillah, even if the secular scholarship has a bed, the secular scholarship never talks about Dajjal. And tonight we want to expose that secular scholarship. And we will continue doing it, inshallah. Because the secular scholarship will be taken for a ride and will misguide those who follow the secular scholarship. it is important that Islamic scholarship must have its voice heard. Islamic scholarship, and only Islamic scholarship, can explain the world today. The Quran, and only the Quran, can explain the world today. And you cannot explain the world today without Dajjal. And yet, they never talk about Dajjal. And so tonight, we expose them. In this book, written and republished here in Malaysia, Malaysian artists gave me this design. Jerusalem in the Quran, Jerusalem dalam di Quran, Jerusalem dalam di Quran. Di dalam Quran. Okay. Not bad, right? Written 10 years ago. And this book began the process of explaining that job. They laugh at me. They mock me. They scoff at me. They marginalize me. They dismiss me. They will not respond to this book. No. But I want you to follow them. 15 years ago, because of my study of the subject of Dajjal, I said that the US dollar has to collapse. And that when the US dollar collapses, it will bring down the whole world of paper money with it. They laughed at me at that time, but they're not laughing anymore now. They're not laughing anymore now. For the last 1 year, I have been saying that Israel is going to bring back the gold and silver coins. And Israel will be assisted by modern Western civilization. So gold and silver coins are going to come back in the world. Where did I get the knowledge from? They don't talk about that. Have you ever heard them say that? I ask you tonight, have you ever heard them say this? That Israel is going to bring back gold and silver coins? No. They never spoke about it because they don't know that. And yet they are experts. And they scoff at Imran Hosein. But praise be to Allah that we have survived. Where did Imran Hosein get the knowledge from? Where? It is from the Quran and from Nabi Muhammad alayhi salam. And so tonight, whether the secular scholarship is in the national university or in the Islamic university, or in the Prime Minister's department, or wherever the secular scholarship is. Tonight we say to them, come to Islam, come to the Quran. With that introduction, who is Dajjal? There is a chapter in this book on the subject. And the book is also translated into Bahasa. But we only have about 10 copies tonight, sorry. we have to reprint. It'll probably take about 2 weeks, 3 weeks to get it reprinted. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made a promise to Banu Israel that He would send them one who would be a prophet, their prophet, and who would be known as Al-Masih, the Messiah. And who, when He comes, would bring back the golden age. Zaman Mas? Good Basa.
Good Basa.
He'll make back the golden age. Zaman Mas. When Nabi Dawood alayhi salam and Nabi Sulaiman alayhi salam rule the world from the holy state of Israel in the Holy Land. A ruling state is a state whose power cannot be rivaled and cannot be challenged. So in this sense, Israel, Holy Israel, was the ruling state. But then came Allah's punishment, and it was destroyed. وَقَدَيْنَا إِلَىٰ بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلَ فِي الْكِتَابِ لَتُفْسِدُنَّ فِي الْأَرْضِ مَرَّتَيْنِ وَلَتَعَلُنَّ عُلُوًا كَبِيرًا. They violated the condition of residence in the Holy Land, and Allah expelled them. Destroyed the holy state of Israel. Destroyed the masjid built by Sulaiman alayhi salam. And they were taken into slavery in Babylon. And then came the promise of Al-Masih, the Messiah, who will bring back that golden age, who would therefore rule the world. Nabi Muhammad sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, his voice is the most powerful voice in history to prophesy that the true Messiah, Nabi Isa alayhi salam, Jesus the son of Mary, will return. And when He returns, He will be Hakim, the one who rules, not downtown Chicago. Rather, He would be the ruling power in the world, in the sense that there can be no rival to challenge His power. And that He would be Hakim, Hakimun Adil. He would rule with justice. When Allah sent the Messiah to Banu Israel, He tested them, as He is testing us now and all of us. Illa masha'Allah, all of us are failing. All of us are failing. Illa masha'Allah. So this lecture is a wake-up call for you and for me. He tested them, and they failed the test. They said, he is a bastard. Wa na'udhu billah min hadha. Waladu zina. Bastard. But they were wrong. His mother gave birth to him while yet a virgin. She was not married. So when he declared that he is Al-Masih, the Messiah, they rejected him. Why? Because he's a bastard. Bastard cannot be the Messiah. And when they saw him die on the cross, before their very eyes, they saw him die. They boasted. Boasted. We've killed him. He cannot be the Messiah. Why? He's dead. He never ruled the world. Zaman must never came back to us. What they did not know. No one knew. None. And no one knew until the Quran came. Was it no, they did not succeed in killing him. No, they did not succeed in crucifying him. Allah made it appear like that. Allah raised him. So he did not experience maut. We will have another lecture, inshallah, on an Islamic view of the return of Nabi Isa alayhi salam, when we will deal with the subject in greater detail, inshallah. Only the Quran had this information, that they did not kill him. But they didn't know that. He's dead. So he cannot be the Messiah. And so they're still waiting for the Messiah to come. Nabi Muhammad sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam told us that Allah created an evil being. Can Allah create evil? Kul, a'udhu bi rabbil falaq. What comes after? In shabri ma khalaq. Yes, Allah can create evil. This is the evil that Allah created. Kul a'udhu bi rabbil falaq min shabri ma khalaq. Where is the shabr that Allah created? Here is the shabr that Allah created. An evil being who is given the name Dajjal, one who deceives. So I said, and somebody got very angry with me because he just did his PhD. I said, Dajjal has a PhD in deception. Sheikh Imran, don't say that. He just got his PhD. He deceives. He's also known as Al-Masih Dajjal. Dajjal who will claim to be Al-Masih, the Messiah. They got the prophecy that Allah was going to send them a Messiah who will bring back Zaman Mas while they were in Babylon. And the Holy Land is under Babylonian occupation. So they knew that in order for the Messiah to rule the world from Jerusalem, number one, he would have to liberate the Holy Land for Banu Israel. Number two, he would have to bring Banu Israel back to the Holy Land to reclaim it as their own. Number three, he would have to restore the holy state of Israel in the Holy Land. Allah had destroyed it. And number four, he would have to cause that state of Israel to become once again the ruling state in the world. And then the Messiah can rule the world. If Dajjal is to successfully impersonate the Messiah, if he is to stand up in Jerusalem and declare, I am the Messiah, number one, he'll have to be a human being. Why? Because Nabi Isa alayhi salam is a human being. Simple, isn't it? If he comes as a donkey, how can he claim to be the Messiah? Huh? He has to come as a human being. So leave that, that's too simple. Number one, he will have to liberate the Holy Land from Banu Israel. Well, he's already done that. It happened in 1917. Perhaps you were not born as yet, were you? 1917. Number two, he'd have to bring the Jews back to the Holy Land to reclaim it as their own. He's already done that. He's already done that. Between 1917 and 1948, while we were drinking tea tariq. Number three, he will have to restore his state of Israel in the Holy Land. An imposter. But get people to believe this is Holy Israel. He's already done that. He's already done that. This imposter state of Israel was born in 1948 when Imran Hosein was 6 years of age. So I thank Allah I was born at the correct time. Perfect timing. Number four, he will have to cause that state of Israel to become the ruling state in the world. And Israel is now one step away from ruling the world. Where are your secular scholars? Did we continue, Terry? Where is that secular scholarship that has been scoffing at Imran Hosein, dismissing him? Are they drinking tea tariq? Israel is one step away. Israel already controls the US Congress. And Israel declares that publicly. We control the US Congress. And the United States is the ruling state in the world. So from behind the hijab, Israel is already ruling the world. And so if tomorrow, I may not be around, I'm close to 70 now. If tomorrow you see Israel starts to mint gold coins and bring them in the market, you know that Dajjal is about to appear. And I ask you, where is secular scholarship? How come they don't talk about it? If I raise my voice, it's because of my anger of those who are parading as scholars and misleading the people. And would not talk about Dajjal. If I raise my voice sufficiently, maybe tomorrow you're going to hear them talking about Dajjal. That's what I want to do. Force them, push them, embarrass them until they start to talk about Dajjal. In order for Dajjal to rule the world, Israel must rule the world. In order for Israel to rule the world, Israel must rule the Arabs. Now you can understand the Arab uprisings. Egypt, Tunisia. Huh? So that when Israel unleashes her great wars, which should be maybe 1 year, 2 years from now, I don't think more than that, Israel will be able to say to the world, Islam is rising. And Islam is becoming a menace to mankind, to Israel. CNN broadcasting 7 days of the week, 24 hours of the day. Islam is rising, menacing mankind. When Israel wages these big wars, it will not only be to control the Arabs. You can't control so many Arabs. You're going to have to make the Arab population small. How are you going to do that? Huh? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, but you don't hear secular scholarship talking about it. No, they don't talk about it. He said the Arabs will be wiped out by plague, epidemic. We just had something called swine flu. Huh? Something called AIDS. He said the Arabs are going to be wiped out by plague. So millions and millions of Arabs would die. This is prophecy. When Israel wages the big wars, she has to expand her territory. Why? Because the Bible says that the Holy Land extends from the river of Egypt to the river Euphrates. But that's a lie. That's a lie. But it is there in the Bible. And so, I hope I'm not getting a virus. Inshallah. Because it is in the Bible, they can't do otherwise. They have to expand their territory. And so take control of the Suez Canal. And take control of the oil of the Gulf. Israel cannot wage those big wars. Put on your thinking cap. While Muslims still have a weapon that can destroy Israel. And therefore Pakistan's nuclear plants and Pakistan's nuclear weapons will have to be destroyed. And so the fashion something, they engineered something called 9/11 to take care of Pakistan. 9/11 was created and executed in order to take care of Pakistan, to destroy Pakistan's nuclear plants and nuclear weapons and break up Pakistan. And so when the big wars start, which should be soon, we will most certainly see an attack on Pakistan. Where is secular scholarship? How come if you are scholars of Islam, so to say, how come you don't talk about this? What's wrong with you? If I push hard enough, I might get them to talk. In order for Israel to rule the world, Israel has to impose upon all of mankind a political dictatorship. a world government. We are now, we have arrived at world government. As Muammar Gaddafi in Libya is telling you. In order for Israel to rule the world, Israel has to impose an economic dictatorship. And Israel has to impose a monetary dictatorship upon mankind. And so when Sunnah money, I coined the phrase Sunnah money many years ago, the gold dinar and silver dirham, when it disappeared from the market, it did not disappear by accident, you dum-dum. When will you wake up? There is a reason why the gold dinar and silver dirham disappeared from the market, but they will not tell you. Force them to tell you. Ask them, why did the gold dinar and silver dirham disappear from the market? Ask them. They will have to answer you one day, because Imran Hosein is here to expose them. That secular scholarship has to be sent to Singapore. Let it remain there. But when the next tsunami comes, you say, goodbye, Singapore. We're not missing you anymore. Because you pay the Indonesian daughter of mine $300 a wage that no Singaporean woman will work for. That is oppression. At $300 is oppression. And Islam has zero tolerance for oppression. And Allah will destroy you for your oppression. So when the next tsunami comes, goodbye Singapore, we're not going to miss you. That secular scholarship has to be exposed. That political dictatorship is already here. That economic dictatorship is already here. That monetary dictatorship is already here. You got homework to do if you are 21 years of age. And the reason why it is here is so that one people might rule the world. My guess is that it will not take more than maybe 20, 25 years before Israel rules the world and the false Messiah emerges in Jerusalem. But where is he now? A companion of the Prophet ﷺ came to him in Medina. He was a Christian, he became Muslim. His name was Tamim al-Dari, and narrated to him an experience he had. When I analyze it, my understanding is that this was a vision. But you are free to have your own understanding. The Prophet ﷺ then said to the people, sit down. Tamim al-Dari has come to me and told me something about Dajjal which confirms what I have been saying to you. And now we get the event from the lips of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The Tamim al-Dari and some 40 of his companions went on board a ship from the Arab lands. And a ship normally travels on water, doesn't it? Normally, yeah. And the storm came and blew the ship for a whole month, until they came to land. And it was an island, that's what the hadith said. And when they got on shore, on the land, they were confronted by a very hairy creature. So much hair, they could not tell which side was head and which side was tail. The creature said that I am Jassasa. Wala Tajassasu. Do not spy. Someone should tell that special branch for me. So Jasasa means spy. So this is an island about 1 month's journey by sailing ship from the Arab world, which has an excellence in spying and espionage, James Bond kind of stuff. Jasasa said to them, go over there, there's someone waiting to see you. And they went and they found a monastery lying in ruins. And so this is an island in which religion will eventually collapse and crumble. Eventually it will be atheist. And they will sell their church for KFC. And another church will be sold to McDonald's hamburgers. Huh? Because nobody going to church. So they rush. And there they found a man in chains, his hands chained to his neck, and his feet chained. And the man started to question them. Has that Nabi al-Ummi, the Nabi who is not a Jew, has he arrived in Medina? They said yes. Are the people following him? They said, some are and some are not. He said, they should follow him, that would be better for them. He asked, is there any water left in the Sea of Galilee? They said, yes, plenty, plenty water. He said, it will soon dry up. And then he said, I am Dajjal. When I am released, I will enter every town and every city, but he did not mention kampung. So at the time when Tamim al-Dari narrated this event to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Dajjal was still in chains on that island. Not yet released. But shortly after that, Nabi Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam suspected a Jewish boy whose name was Ibn Isfayyad in Medina to be Dajjal. Suspected. So he took Umar radiallahu ta'ala with him to go and question the boy. But the boy was impertinent, disrespectful in his answer. So Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu said, O Messenger of Allah, give me permission and cut off his neck. No, Umar, don't do that. If he is Dajjal, you cannot kill him. And if he is not Dajjal, it would be sinful to kill him. If he is Dajjal, implies that the possibility exists. But that possibility could only exist if Dajjal was released. So now we know from this event, Nabi Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam is conveying the information that the release of Dajjal has now taken place. The last prophet has come. The Jews have rejected him. And Allah has released released Dajjal. But then where is he? It could not have been Ibn Isfayyad because he died. He was buried. Could not be Ibn Isfayyad. He also became a Muslim. The Prophet said, sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, that when Dajjal is released, he will live on earth for 40 days. One day like a year. Yawmun kasana. One day like a month. Yawmun kashahr. One day like a week. Yawmun kajum'ah. وَسَائِرُ أَيَّامِهِ كَأَيَّامِكُمْ. And all his days, meaning all the rest of his days, like your days. When his day is like our day, he would be in our world. So we would see him. He would be a Jew. He would be born of Jewish parents. He would be a Jew. He would be a young man. He would be powerfully built. He would have curly hair. And where would he be? In Jerusalem. But where would he be in a day which is like a year? And if we are alive at that time, how would we perform salah in a day which is like a year? They asked. Our lecture tonight devotes attention to this subject. When Dajjal is in a day which is like a year, he commences his mission from this island. And we have identified the island in this book. You will see the photograph. There are three blue circles. Three blue circles. The book is at the back. There's a table at the back where the book is available. The English book. Bahasa is only about 11 copies we have. We have identified the island as Britain. But you don't have to agree with us. If you want to say Singapore, that's up to you. After all, Singapore is the Israel, everybody knows that. When Dajjal is in a day like a year, Britain became the ruling state. And the phrase was coined Pax Britannica. Britain rules. Did this happen by accident? Come on, secular scholarship. Come on, we want to hear from you. They don't talk. They're so silent. And then when Dajjal moved to a day which is like a month, Pax Britannica gave way to Pax Americana. And the United States became the ruling state in the world. But the United States rules the world for a much shorter period of time than Britain. That was a day like a year. This is a day like a month. And now, Obama or no Obama, the United States is in a state of decline. The US dollar is in hospital. Everybody knows that. And a day which is like a month is coming to an end. And a day which is like a week is starting and beginning. And so Pax Americana has to give way to a third ruling state. Which will it be? Only Islamic scholarship can speak on this subject. Not Princeton, not Yale, not Harvard, not Oxford, not Cambridge. Only Islamic scholarship.
Not that secular scholarship that is parading as Islamic scholarship. No!
Only Islamic scholarship can speak these words. That a new ruling state has to replace the United States.
No, it's not going to be China. Forget that.
We say it will be Israel. And that in the same way that Pax Americana replaced Pax Britannica, so too will Pax Judaica. Pax Judaica, meaning Israel as the ruling state, will replace Pax Americana. This is the ground, the footprints on the ground of the Dajjal moving through these three stages. But where is he? Obviously, a day which is like a year is not our world of space and time. A day which is like a month is not our world of space and time. A day which is like a week is not our world of space and time. هو الذي خلق لكم ما في الأرض جميعا ثم استوى إلى السماء فسواهن سبع سماوات وهو بكل شيء عليم. After Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created the material universe. The word arm means earth, but the word abd also means the material universe. After Allah created the material universe, then He directed His attention to the sky and He fashioned it. Sawwahunna. He fashioned it into seven samawat, seven worlds of space and time between this world and that world. There is only one surah of the Quran which is linked to Dajjal. Which is it? Huh? Surah Al-Kahfi. And the Prophet said, recite the first 10 ayat of Surah Al-Kahfi for protection from the fitna of the Dajjal. So you better memorize it when you reach immigration. Eh? In Surah Al-Kahfi, there is the story of the young man in the cave. That they fled from the world of shirk. Only the young will do that.
And they fled to a cave and Allah protected them. And they slept for 300 years. And then Allah woke them up. لِنَعْلَمَ أَيُّ الْحِزْبَيْنِ أَحْصَى لِمَا لَبِثُوا أَمَدًا.
So this miracle of sleeping for 300 years was not for protection from that world. This miracle of sleeping for 300 years was meant to teach a lesson about time.
I'm sorry I didn't have to bring the book with me, it's at the back. It is Surah Al-Kahfi and the Modern World. And chapter 2 of that book is the Quran and time. So when they woke up, they asked each other, how long have we been here? And one of them said, a day or a part of a day. So Imran Hosein asked, what happened? Were you blind? Can't you see?
If you sleep for 300 years, then when you wake up, your fingernails will be as long as from Ampah Point to KL, it's seen. And your beard from Kuala Lumpur to Penang. 300 years. Do you agree with me? 300 years. So how could he say, a day or a part of a day? Answer? They did not age biologically for 300 years. They were the same age as when they went to sleep. So they were not in our world of space and time. They were in another world of space and time where women don't need cosmetics. You remain forever young. In other words, they were in another sama. So Allah is teaching us with Surah Al-Kahfi about the Samawat. So they were not in this world. No, they could not be in this world. Why? Because they did not age biologically. They had to be in another world of space and time, another sama. Okay, you agree with me? Wrong. They had to be in this world. Wrong. They had to be in this world. Why? Because in the morning the sunlight will come from the right side. And in the evening, the sunlight would come from the left side. Morning and evening belong to this world. وَنُقَلِّبُهُمْ ذَاتَ الْيَمِينِ وَذَاتَ الشِّمَالِ. And the bodies were rolling to the right in the morning, to the left in the evening. So this is evidence that they were in this world. We have a problem here. So we don't need Stephen Hawking. The Quran is teaching us. The Quran is teaching us that they were in both the worlds. They were in this world and yet in another world at the same time. And so Dajjal is in another world and yet constantly in this world, spending most of his time in Saudi Arabia. You didn't know that. And so the movement between different Samawat can be constant, constant movement back and forth. Then there is the story in Surah Al-Baqarah of the traveler who was traveling by the city of Jerusalem, which was lying in ruins. He said, I don't think that Allah could ever raise his back again. And Allah caused him to die for how long? How long? 100 years. And then Allah raised him back. How long have you been here? He said, a day or part of a day. Allah said, no, you've been here for 100 years. Now look at your food. Roti canai. Look at your food. Lam yatasanna. The food is still fresh after 100 years.
So the food survived in a different world of space and time. Now look at your donkey.
Donkey died.
The donkey rotted. The donkey became dust. And then Allah caused the donkey to be revived. So the donkey was in this world of space and time, and the food was in another world of space and time, in the same place. So if you want to travel from this world of space and time to the Sama al-Dunya, you don't need to take a taxi. No, you step in and you step out. What vehicle do you need to travel back and forth between the different worlds of space and time? Remind me to tell you what the vehicle is. Number three, Nabi Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam is asleep at the Kaaba, and Burak takes him, and Burak travels at such a speed that every step traverses the horizon. Nabi Muhammad is traveling in a different world of space and time with Burak. But look at the divine wisdom. Burak stops and comes down in the night time, because a caravan had camped for the night, and there was a container with water, and there was a lid on the container. You remember? Come on, shake your head, you remember? Nabi Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam got off Burak, removed the lid, drank the water, put the lid back. A second time Burak came down. A caravan was camped and a camel had broken loose. He called out to the people, "Wake up, your camel has broken loose." Why did this happen? Not only to prove that this journey did take place, that's one reason. But the other reason is to demonstrate that it is possible to travel back and forth between that world of space and time and this world of space and time. And so Dajjal, when he is released on earth, is not in our world of space and time, but he is on earth. Are angels in our world of space and time? No, no. Can we see them? No. But are they here? Of course they are here. Every one of us have two angels. But they're here on earth, but you can't see them. Are there jinn on earth? Huh? Plenty in Washington. Can we see the jinn? No. But they're here on earth? No. Similarly, Dajjal is here on earth, but we cannot see him. He is operating in the political process. He is operating in the economic process. He is the mastermind behind the modern age. He is the mastermind who created modern Western civilization. But we cannot see him because he is not in our world of space and time. He is in the Samawat. But when Israel wages a big war, and Israel replaces the United States as the ruling state of the world, and Israel rules the world for a day which is like a week, Yawm al-Jum'ah, then at the end of that, Dajjal will now enter into our world of space and time. He born as a Jew and grew up to become a young man, powerfully built, very young. But this will be the end of his mission. He would have been done, he would have already completed all his work. How will we recognize him? Give me 5 more minutes, please. How will we recognize him? You and I will recognize him when Israel is ruling the world. And then this Jew stands up in Jerusalem and says, I am the Messiah. We will say, this is the judge. This is the judge. But that secular scholarship would say, no. No. If he is Dajjal, where is his flying donkey? Where is his flying donkey? The Prophet said that Dajjal will ride on a donkey. The donkey will fly. The donkey has wings. It will fly as fast as the clouds. And the donkey will have his ears stretched out wide. So that secular scholarship would say, where is the flying donkey? You and I know the flying donkey is already here. That is how Imran Hosein was able to leave Trinidad, fly to Caracas, fly to Buenos Aires, fly to Cape Town, to Durban, to Johannesburg, back to Cape Town, to KL. It's a modern aircraft. Because the Dajjal has the modern aircraft, it controls the sky. So when he says, no fly zone, it's no fly zone. Only he can fly, nobody else. When that man stands up in Jerusalem, 25 years from now, I believe, and says, I am the Messiah, and you and I know this is the Dajjal. Secular scholarship would say, no, he cannot be the Dajjal. Why? The Prophet said, the Dajjal sees with one eye, the left eye. He's blind in the right eye. It looks like a bulging grape. Your Lord is not one eye, but this man has two eyes, so he cannot be the Dajjal. So they're going to have to wait now for a man to come with one eye. You and I know that when the Dajjal sees with his left eye, it symbolizes external sight. You and I know that when the Dajjal is blind in his right eye, it symbolizes internal blindness. And all those who follow Dajjal, like secular scholarship, are internally blind. When you are internally blind, what does Allah say about you? They have eyes, but they don't see. They have ears, but they don't hear. They have thoughts, but they do not understand. أُولَٰئِكَ كَالْأَنْعَامِ. They're just like cattle. بَلْ هُمْ أَضَلُّ. Secular scholarship, I hope you're listening. They're worse than cattle. That is what Allah says about people who like Dajjal are internally blind. Islamic scholarship, in order to be Islamic scholarship, must see with two eyes. Now finally, before we end, is it possible to travel to the Samawat? And if we were to go in a year which is a day which is like a year, how will we perform Salah? Is it possible to perform Salat in your grave? What do you say? Huh?
Is it possible to perform salat in your grave? When Nabi Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam went to the Isra and Miraj, he came back, and on his return journey he said, I passed by the grave of Nabi Musa alayhi salam, and I saw him performing salat in his grave. But if you are in your grave, you're not in this material world. So there is no sun and no light and darkness and morning and evening. So how will you perform salat in your grave? Answer, you will have to calculate. If you want to perform salat in another world of space and time, you will have to calculate. Is it possible for us to travel to the Samawat? Is it possible? I know this is the part you're waiting for. Allah gives the answer in Surah An-Nur. He says, Allahu Nur as-Samawat. Did you hear that? Why did I stop? Allahu Nur as-Samawat. Wal-Ard. Samawat. Wal-Ard. So Nur links both Samawat and Ard. So the vehicle for travel between Ard and Samawat is Nur. But this Nur is not sold in the stock market. They don't have this in Washington. No! يَهْدِ اللَّهُ لِنُورِهِ مَنْ يَشَّى. Only Allah can give that Noor to whomsoever He wishes. It is with that Noor that one can travel through the Samawat and the Ard. This is all I will say on the subject. Beyond this, you have to go to the authentic Sufi Sheikh, like Imam Al-Ghazali, rahimahullah. They are the masters. Imam Maulana Jalaluddin Rumi, rahimahullah. They are the masters. All that I have done is to give you the vehicle through which you can travel to other worlds of space and time. I pray. One last word. You cannot penetrate the Quran without knowing. The intellect is not enough. And there are passages in the Quran that Allah has conceived from those who don't. You know the secular scholarship, they don't really believe in life hereafter. وَإِذَا قَرَأْتَ الْقُرْآنَ جَعَلْنَا بَيْنَكَ وَبَيْنَ الَّذِينَ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ بِالْآخِرَةِ هِجَابًا مَسْتُورًا. When you recite the Quran, we place between you and them that secular scholarship that never talks about the Dajjal. We place a hijab, a barrier, a hijab, which is mastur, covered. So covering upon covering. It is only with Noor that you can penetrate the Quran. And only the Quran can explain the world today. Your brother Imran Hosein is doing a very humble job of simply laying the foundation. There are other scholars to come. Believe me when I speak. One of them might be in this gathering. A young man. There is a tomorrow which is going to come.
when the Quran is going to dazzle mankind. سَنُرِيهِمْ آيَاتِنَا فِي الْآفَاقِ وَفِي أَنفُسِهِمْ حَتَّى يَتَبَيَّنَ لَهُمْ أَنَّهُ الْحَقِّ. This Quran is going to dazzle the world. This Quran has a glorious role to play yet at the end of history. Only the Quran can explain the world. Who are going to be those scholars? Those lucky ones chosen by Allah. Tonight, I want you to put it in your heart. Oh Allah, I want to be one of those. Put it in your heart, if you are 17 or 18 or 20 years of age. Put it in your heart, oh Allah, I want to be one of those. Through whom the Quran is going to dazzle the world. But you will not succeed, my son, unless there is nur. And nur comes only from Allah. ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم وتب علينا يا مولانا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين آمين يا رب العالمين. Bring back gold and silver coins? No. They never talk about it because they don't know that. And yet they are experts. And they scoff at Imran Hosein. But praise be to Allah that we have survived. Where did Imran Hosein get the knowledge from? Where? It is from the Quran and from Nabi Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam. And so tonight, whether the secular scholarship is in the national university or in the Islamic university or in the Prime Minister's department or wherever the secular scholarship is, tonight we say to them, come to Islam. Come to the Quran. With that introduction, who is Dajjal? There is a chapter in this book on the subject. And the book is also translated into Bahasa. But we only have about 10 copies tonight. Sorry. We have to reprint. It'll probably take about 2 weeks, 3 weeks to get it reprinted. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made a promise to Banu Israel that he would send them one who would be a prophet, their prophet, and who would be known as Al-Masih, the Messiah. And who, when he comes, would bring back the golden age, Zaman Mas, secular scholarship declares, Alhamdulillah, even if the secular scholarship has a bed, the secular scholarship never talks about Dajjal. And tonight, we want to expose that secular scholarship. And we will continue doing it, inshallah. Because the secular scholarship will be taken for a ride. And will misguide those who follow the secular scholarship.
it is important that Islamic scholarship must have its voice heard. Islamic scholarship, and only Islamic scholarship, can explain the world today. The Quran, and only the Quran, can explain the world today. And you cannot explain the world today without Dajjal. And yet, they never talk about Dajjal. And so tonight, we expose them. In this book, written and published here in Malaysia, Malaysian artists gave me this design. Jerusalem in the Quran, Jerusalem dalam di Quran, Jerusalem dalam di Quran. Di dalam Quran. Okay. Not bad, right? Written 10 years ago. And this book began the process of explaining Dajjal. They laugh at me. They mock me. They scoff at me. They marginalize me. They dismiss me. They will not respond to this book. No. But I want you to follow them. 15 years ago, because of my study of the subject of Dajjal, I said that the US dollar has to collapse. And that when the US dollar collapses, it will bring down the whole world of paper money with it. They laughed at me at that time, but they're not laughing anymore now. They're not laughing anymore now. For the last 1 year, I have been saying that Israel is going to bring back the gold and silver coins. And Israel will be assisted by modern Western civilization. So gold and silver coins are going to come back in the world. Where did I get the knowledge from? They don't talk about that. Have you ever heard them say that? I ask you tonight, have you ever heard them say?
عباده الذين اصطفى خصوصا على أفضلهم وخاتم النبيين محمد الأمين وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين وبعد. Brother Chairman, respected Imam, brothers and sisters, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Wa alaikum salam wa rahmatullahi.
We begin with Allah's blessed name. We praise Him and we glorify Him as He ought to be praised and glorified.
This is not very successful.
And we pray for peace and for blessings on all his noble messengers, and in particular on the last of them all, the blessed Prophet Muhammad sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. And we thank Allah for the opportunity to be with you here in Masjid al-Husna, in Sunway Pyramid, in Kuala Lumpur, in Malaysia. I got it right?
Yeah.
To address you on a subject which is not simple, not easy, and yet of critical importance. In fact, the government of Malaysia should be here to listen. The subject of Dajjal and the Samawat. Dajjal and the Samawat. We begin the lecture by defining who or what is Dajjal. We then proceed to explain his mission that Allah gave to him. And then to try to assess how much of that mission he has already accomplished and how much remains. And if he has already accomplished part of his mission, where is he? And that will take us to the Samawat. Let us, at the very beginning, point out that there is a profound difference between Islamic scholarship and secular scholarship. Even if the secular